afternoon, Tomah VA veterans. While we wait for phones to dial, we want to remind you, Tomah VA veterans, of the important resources we have available for you. First off, we have the Veterans Crisis Line, which is always available by dialing 988 and pressing 1. The Veterans Crisis Line provides a safe and supportive space for all veterans and their loved ones. Please add 988 to your contact today. Another resource available is the convenient refilling of our prescription remotely with the use of Audio Care Prefill. What is Audio Care Prefill? Audio Care Prefill is a system that utilizes automated calls or text messages to notify veterans when their prescription medication is close to running out. Veterans will then have the option to request a refill or renewal of the prescription by responding to the automated text or phone call prompts. The benefits of using Audio Care Prefill is that you'll stay on track with your medications and receive your refills timely. As we know, refill medications are not automatic within VA system, so this is a great option to make sure that you don't forget to refill your medications. The third resource we wanted to remind you today is we also encourage veterans to like our Facebook page, where we routinely provide national and local updates about what is happening at the VA, including events like today's Teletown Hall. Coming up next month, we are partnering with the La Crosse County Veterans Service Office to hold a Veterans Benefit Checkup event at the Omni Center in Onalaska on October 12th from 9 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. Our whole health department is also hosting several fall into wellness expos starting October 7th through October 10th, located in Wausau, Tomah, Wisconsin Rapids, and Onalaska. We will have more information about these events on the call today. Please watch our social media and website for more information on upcoming events. Stay on the line, and we will begin our town hall shortly. All right, good afternoon, and welcome to the Tomah VA Medical Center's live telephone town hall. My name is Dr. Brian Prahlman, and I am your associate director here at the Tomah VA. I'll be your moderator for this afternoon's call. We are fortunate to have presenters from Tomah VA's leadership team, as well as other subject matter experts, to provide programming updates. This includes our Medical Center Director, Ms. Karen Long, our Chief of Staff, Dr. Mary Ellis, our Nurse Executive, Ms. Molly Ritter. We also have with us today Ms. Kelly Joyce of the Whole Health Department as the Director, Ms. Nicole Ravenscroft, the Health Promotion Disease Prevention Program Manager, that's a mouthful, and Ms. Katrin Metcalf, our Telehealth Coordinator, and Dr. Michael Nagy, our Endocrine Pharmacy Practitioner, as well as Ms. Natalie Dorfler, a nurse practitioner at the Tomah VA. In addition, we also have subject matter experts, as always, in enrollment eligibility, beneficiary travel, community care, and our partners from Veterans Benefit Administration, also known as VBA, to answer your questions today. We hope you stay on the line with us, and I encourage you to participate in a question-answer session that will follow today's presentation. If you'd like to ask a question at any time, please just press *3 on your phone and you'll be connected to one of our operators. This will get you into the queue for an opportunity to ask your question. You can begin calling in with questions now. Questions will be answered after our announcements have been made. If you get disconnected for any reason or need to call back in, please call us back at 833-305-1703. Again, that's 833-305-1703. Please also note today we are testing our fire alarms inside of the building at Tomah VA, so if you hear any alarms, please note that's just a test. And with that, let's start our town hall off with a message from the Medical Center Director.
Hi, thanks Dr. Prahl, and thank you to all the veterans joining the call. We look forward to hearing from you all today. At today's telephone town hall, we will provide an update on the PACT Act. We will hear about exciting things going on at our Women's Health Center. After that, we'll hear from our Whole Health regarding upcoming opportunities where you can learn about the experience wellness strategies that empower healthy living. Then we will provide information on telehealth and VA Video Connect, which is timely for the upcoming winter months. Finally, we will discuss endocrine services at the Tomah VA and our outpatient clinic. Throughout the call, we will have some polling questions that you will be able to answer. Thank you again for joining our call today.
All right. Thank you, Ms. Long. We will now hear from Ms. Natalie Dorfler regarding the PACT Act.
My name is Natalie Dorfler. I'm honored to serve as a nurse practitioner within Tomah VA's Medical Center's Military Environmental Exposure Clinic as PACT Act Implementation Lead, Environmental Health Registry Clinician, and Toxic Exposure Navigator. My role and that of my teams is to readily assist our veterans with health care and related needs resulting from or presumed to be caused by military environmental exposures, to include Agent Orange, airborne hazard open burn pits, Gulf War, ionizing radiation, Camp Lejeune, and garrison exposures. We provide information on health conditions that may arise from exposure history, as well as to assist you, the veteran, to navigate the Veterans Health Administration. This includes your journey from enrollment and registration of healthcare services to healthcare evaluation of exposure-related health issues, as well as to provide resources and connect you with follow-up for your benefits and claims questions and needs. Tomah VA Medical Center consistently ranks within the top 5 facilities nationally for the percentile of completed toxic exposure screenings. To date, Tomah VA Medical Center has completed 20,217 toxic exposure screenings in primary and specialty clinics and at outreach events. Although we have provided toxic exposure screenings to the majority of our catchment area for Tomah VA Medical Center, our focus now remains the approximate 22% left to be screened for toxic exposures to ensure their health care needs are met and related services provided. We are working to provide military exposure-informed care with ease of access in every way possible. As part of our military environmental exposure-informed care across primary and specialty clinics, we encourage you to register for health care and establish with VA primary care. If you have any military exposure-related health concerns and/or treatment questions or concerns, please contact your provider. It is advisable to notify any community care providers of your toxic exposure history for continuity of health care. If you have service connection-related claims or questions, you are encouraged to contact the Veterans Benefits Administration at 1-800-827-1000 or online at www.va.gov/disability for your county veteran service officer. For military environmental exposure is open. And to determine eligibility for appointment scheduling, please contact the Tomah VA Medical Center Environmental Health Clinic at 608-372-3971, extension 66925. Thank you.
Excellent. Thank you, Ms. Storfler. As a quick recap, toxic exposure, we're in top 5 in the nation, but again, we still have work to do, and we need your help. Please encourage your fellow veterans to call in and get screened. And again, that number is 608-372-3971, extension 66925. And if you haven't figured it out, having a pen and paper during these town halls is extremely helpful. With that, we're going to take our first polling question. Polling question number 1. Again, you can use your touchpad on your phone for these answers. Have you been screened for toxic exposure underneath the PACT Act using your telephone? Please press 1 for yes, 2 for no, or 3 if you're not sure. And as we wait for those to come in, we'll have some more information about the PACT Act. You can reach out to our admissions team at 608-372-1751 and or reach out to your local county veteran service officer. You may also read about PACT Act initiatives at va.gov/PACT. That's P-A-C-T. And with that, we have a few votes in. Looks like most votes are for no, and some are for yes. So again, please don't hesitate to reach out to the clinic and see if you can get screened for the toxic exposure. That does help with some of your benefits. We will now hear from Dr. Ellis, our Chief of Staff, with an update regarding our Women's Health Center.
Good afternoon. My name is Dr. Mary Ellis. I'm the Chief of Staff for the Tomah VA. We are thrilled to announce that we have celebrated the grand opening of our new Women's Health Center at the Tomah VA Medical Center. This center is not just a building, but a symbol of our commitment to providing comprehensive, compassionate, and personalized care to the women who have served our nation with distinction. The Women's Health Care Center reflects our recognition of the evolving needs of female veterans and our dedication to meeting those needs with the highest standards of medical excellence. Here we offer a wide range of services, including primary care, gynecologic and reproductive health consults, health coaching, peer support, maternity care coordination, and mental health support. We encourage you to stop by to see our new home, and if you are a female veteran, we invite you to make an appointment with one of our medical staff members. Additionally, we are very excited to introduce our new Women's Veterans Program Manager, Laura Damro, RN. Laura is a lifelong resident of Tomah, so some of you may recognize her name, and she has over 20 years of experience as a full-scope certified nurse midwife within the Mayo healthcare system. Most recently, she served as a nurse educator at the Tomah VA. Laura is passionate, and I say that with all trueness, that she is incredibly passionate about women's healthcare and believes that as caregivers, we often take care of others before we take care of ourselves. She strives to be a positive advocate for change, supporting the journey of each of us that each of us is on. Laura can be reached at 608-372-3971, which is the main VA number, extension 66375. And finally, I'm pleased to introduce a new program called Thrive. Thrive is a whole health 14-week program that brings women together to discuss a variety of health topics, including sleep, intuitive nutrition, happiness, financial health, stress reduction, creativity, sexual health, mindfulness, and rediscovery of your life's purpose. Women who complete the Thrive program have demonstrated improvements in mental health, quality of life, and reductions in pain. That's all I have for you today. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ellis. That is a lot of information about our new Women's Health Center. Again, some of the key recaps there is our new Women's Veteran Program Manager, Laura Damro, who can be reached at extension 66375. With this, we're going to move to our second polling question for our female veterans. Are you interested in the Thrive or other whole health programs that you just heard about? Please press 1 for yes or press 2 for no. These answers do help us provide the right resources for these programs. And if you're interested in Thrive or other whole health programs, please contact us at 608-372-3971, extension 61417. All right, looks like we have a great number of votes coming in with a lot of people saying yes, they are interested in programs, which is excellent. And with that, we're going to move on to our third topic. This one is going to actually be for the Medical Center Director, who's going to give us an update on comp and pen.
So I want to take this time to provide you with information regarding past neurology compensation and pension exams conducted at the Tomah VA here. So on November 2nd, 2023, Secretary McDonough signed an equitable relief package that would offer new disability exams to 649 veterans whose disability compensation claims may have been negatively impacted by exams conducted by Dr. Mary Jo Lanska, a former VA neurologist at the Tomah VA Medical Center in Tomah, Wisconsin. So VA is using these new exams to re-adjudicate the original claims filed by these veterans, meaning they would not have to file a new claim, and they could be eligible for years of benefits backdated to their original effective date. So we have directly contacted each of these veterans to encourage them to schedule a new exam as soon as possible. And for veterans who have passed away since the original exam, we've contacted their survivors to offer them an opportunity to request re-adjudication as well. Veterans Benefits Administration Milwaukee Regional Office continues to make follow-up contact with these remaining eligible veterans and their survivors who have not yet opted into the program to ensure they meet the one-year deadline of December 4th, 2024. So that date is critical, December 4th, 2024, to get your request in.
We apologize to all the veterans and families who have been negatively impacted. In all cases, we do really encourage you to reach out if you are wanting a new exam as soon as possible. So if you have any questions, please reach out to our patient advocates here locally. The number is 608-372-3971, and the extension is 64775. Again, that's 608-372-3971, and the extension is 64775. And also the contact information for VBA is 1-800-827-1000. And again, that's 1-800-827-1000, and that's for the VBA.
Thank you, Ms. Song. And as I said, I was not joking when you need a pen and paper for these town halls. A lot of information coming your way. And as a reminder, please press *3 on your phones if you have questions, and we will get you connected with one of our operators to take down your question. Next, we're going to turn this over to Ms. Kelly Joyce and Ms. Nicole Ravenscroft to share updates on our whole health programs.
Good afternoon. My name is Kelly Joyce. I am the Whole Health Clinical Director in Tomah. I have with me today Nicole Ravenscroft, who is the Health Promotion Disease Prevention Program Manager.
Happy to be here.
All right, we are excited to share information about our upcoming Fall into Wellness Expo. It's scheduled the first full week of October. You may begin to notice flyers and social media announcements in the coming weeks to remind you about the event. But we are going to tell you a little more today so that you can plan to attend a Fall into Wellness event in one of our locations, including Wausau, Wisconsin Rapids, Onalaska, or Tomah. So what is Fall into Wellness about? Well, VA recognizes the power of personal goals, daily actions, health choices, and specifically how these behaviors impact overall health and well-being. Fall into Wellness Expo will provide an opportunity for participants to learn about and to experience wellness strategies that empower healthy living. The focus of the event will be about greater connections with VA services and accomplishing tasks that impact health. There will be opportunities to observe the use of mobile apps or My Healthy Vet, complete a health personal health inventory, complete body composition testing, participate in a movement experiential like yoga or Tai Chi, ask questions about acupuncture or chiropractic care, and see the tools that the clinicians use. You could receive a flu shot or engage in interactive education about a wide array of topics, and there's so much more. So what do you want your health for? What matters most to you? What are your goals and aspirations? The VA strives to engage with you to address these questions and enrich your health through excellent healthcare. This expo will provide resources to be able to fulfill these meaningful intentions all in one location. You can do it, and we can help. I'm going to hand it over to Nicole to let you know a little bit more about dates and locations.
Absolutely. So first, we're going to start out on Monday, October 7th. From 10 a.m. to 2 up in Wausau at the Marathon County Veterans Service Office. This is located at 212 River Drive in Wausau. Once again, that's on Monday, October 7th. On Tuesday, we'll transition to the Tomah VA and Veterans Hall, building 455, from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. at 500 East Veterans Street in Tomah. On Wednesday, we will be in Wisconsin Rapids. So on Wednesday, October 9th, from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., we'll be right next door at the South Wood County YMCA, which is attached to the Rapids CBOC at 601 West Grand Ave in Wisconsin Rapids. On Thursday, October 10th, we will be at the La Crosse Vet Center from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., which is located at 910 2nd Avenue North in Onalaska. We hope to see you there.
Thank you, Nicole and Kelly, for informing us about great whole health events coming up at the Tomah VA and our outpatient clinics. And it is now time for our third polling question. Let's hear from you. We want to be intentional about engaging in health conversations that are empowering and meaningful. Have you had a conversation with your healthcare team at VA about your mission, aspiration, and purpose, also known as MAP, or what you want for your health? Press 1 for yes or 2 for no. If you'd like to know more, please call Whole Health at 608-372-3971 at extension 61417 between 7:30 in the morning and 4:30 in the afternoon. We are here from Monday through Friday. And looking at all those votes coming in, thank you so much for everyone who is pressing those numbers. Again, that's one for yes, two for no. Looking like we're getting a pretty mixed response on that. Again, that is for the MAP, mission, aspiration, and purpose on what you want your health for. And with that, we're going to move on to our next subject matter expert. We're going to hear from Ms. Katrine Metcalf about telehealth.
Hello, my name is Katrine Metcalf, and I'm the facility telehealth coordinator here at the Tomah VA. The Tomah VA Medical Center has multiple virtual care options available to you. The first one I'd like to focus on is clinical video telehealth. This is where you, the veteran, come to a VA location closest to your home to utilize special equipment, including a digital stethoscope to listen to your heart and lungs, and specialized cameras to look in your ears, nose, and throat. All of these devices connect you to your provider and allow them to do a full clinical assessment. This method is used to bring specialty care closer to the veteran and help omit travel burdens. Tomah is proudly offering partnerships with Madison, Pulmonary, Neurology Services, Cardiology, and Mental Health. And these services are available in all of our CBOCs associated to Tomah. Our next telehealth offering I'd like to highlight is teleretinal imaging. Teleretinal imaging is available at our Tomah VA and our clinics located within La Crosse, Wisconsin Rapids, Wausau, and Clark County. This is for veterans with a diagnosis of diabetes, glaucoma, macular degeneration, or heart disease. The program is used by obtaining images of the back of the eye to monitor and detect specific sight-threatening diseases. These images are obtained in between your in-person visits biannually. This convenient service is completed by a health technician and sent to an optometrist for interpretation, and this is a free with no copay service to the veteran. If you're interested in having your eyes imaged, please reach out to your optometrist or your primary care provider. The last program I'd like to highlight is VA Video Connect, or often called VBC. This program is a VA solution that enables veterans to virtually meet up with their VA healthcare provider using their smart device, whether that be a cell phone, a tablet, a laptop, or a desktop computer equipped with a web camera and microphone. The connection is made utilizing a valid current email address that allows you to connect into an encrypted video platform to ensure the session is secure and private. This allows the veteran to see and talk to their healthcare team from anywhere within the United States. If you'd like to convert over to this platform, please contact your provider to see if your healthcare platform is available with them. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. McCaff. It was nice to hear all the modalities that we offer to our veterans. Again, as a quick recap, we have our virtual care options, clinical video telehealth that brings your local or nearest VA location close to your home to utilize special equipment. This is something that's really emerging with VA to help provide those specialty services for you guys where we can. Again, that teleretinal imaging, free with no cost, can't beat that. And then VA Video Connecting and meeting up with your providers your own healthcare settings, whether that be at your home, on your cell phone, tablet, or laptop. What a great way to connect, and at a very easiest convenience to you. We have a few more polling questions that will be two specifically. The first one is, have you received any services through telehealth? Press one for yes, two for no. Again, have you received any telehealth services? This seems to be the wave of the future as we start reaching out to you and the convenience of your own home. We're getting a lot of mixed answers here, almost 80 answers with a mix. Wow, that jumped up to about 130. It's about a 50-50 split between yes and no's. Thank you so much for answering. We're going to move on to our fifth polling question. If you have not tried telehealth services, would you be willing to try a virtual healthcare option in the future? Again, this helps us determine if we need to invest more resources in these options for you, our patients. Press one for yes and two for no. Would you be willing to try a virtual healthcare option in the future? All right, those responses are coming in. Again, thank you so much for taking those. And if veterans cannot physically make it into the facility or to one of our community-based outpatient clinics, Tomah VA has several telehealth services that are available. If interested, please reach out to your primary care team to utilize these convenient services. Lastly, we have Dr. Michael Nagy, who will be telling us about endocrine services available at the Tomah VA Medical Center and our outpatient clinics.
Oh, thank you. It's a pleasure being here. So I am Dr. Michael Nagy, endocrine pharmacist practitioner here at the Tomah VA and the Associated Outpatient Clinic. Our endocrine clinic was established in April of 2024 due to identified need for these endocrine services for our veterans. Currently, our staff includes an endocrine nurse case manager and myself. The nurse case manager coordinates care for veterans seen in our clinic and provides education on various medications and conditions. I provide care for veterans prescribing medications, managing diagnosed conditions, and monitoring labs. We can offer appointments in all of the ways you've already heard, including over the phone, video visits into the home, telehealth visits in our different community outpatient clinics, as well as in-person visits here in Tomah, and we'll be expanding into Wausau and La Crosse in the coming months. Our services include seeing veterans for the conditions of type 1 and type 2 diabetes, as well as hypo and hyperthyroidism, weight management, osteoporosis, male hypogonadism and testosterone replacement, as well as monitoring after bariatric surgery. Currently, we are not managing insulin pumps. So you might be asking, why choose the Tomah VA for our endocrine care services? We work very closely with your PACT team, and it's keys to communication, as well as results and finding records, and really streamlines your services overall. So we hope you choose the VA.
Thank you very much, Dr. Nagy, for providing insight on this new service offered to our veterans. Again, it's very exciting to see these new services come to the Tomah VA for you, our veterans and our patients. Thank you. We will now have a couple more polling questions, with the polling question number 6 being, do you find value in offering endocrine services at the Tomah VA and outpatient clinics? Press 1 for yes or 2 for no. Do you find value in offering endocrine services at the Tomah VA and outpatient clinics? Press 1 for yes or 2 for no. Several responses are coming in, with the majority of them being for yes, which is excellent, right? That is a service that is there for you. All right, thank you for those questions. We're going to move on to our 7th question, which is, which area would you benefit from an in-person town hall with an expo of services the VA provides? Please press 1 for Tomah, 2 for La Crosse, 3 for Wausau, 4 for Wisconsin Rapids, and 5 for Winona and Houston counties. Again, where would you prefer an in-person town hall with an expo? 1 for Tomah, 2 for La Crosse, 3 for Wausau, 4 for Wisconsin Rapids, and 5 for Winona and Houston counties. Excellent. We're getting a lot of responses. Most of those are for Tomah and La Crosse. Thank you for your input. And thank you to all of our presenters today. We are now going to open up the lines for questions. Again, if you have a question, please press *3 to be connected with one of our operators. Okay. We have Jacobson from West Salem. Jacobson, what is your question?
Hello. Yes.
Hello.
I was referred from a private radiologist to have radiation treatment at the Mayo Clinic in Rochester, and I called the community care office, and they told me that I wouldn't be covered over there because it was out of network. Does that make sense?
That does make sense. And with us today, we have Laura Martin, our Chief of Community Care, to provide an answer for you.
Yes. And Mr. Jacobson, this is Laura. And yes, it is true that Mayo Clinic is out of network. but I think what we'll do is I have your information, And so either myself or one of our nurses will give you a call so we can kind of talk through maybe what some options are for you and how we can help you with this.
Specialized radiation treatment. Yeah. Okay.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. We'll talk to you this afternoon.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Jacobson, for that question. And we're going to go on to question number two from Whiskey, I believe. Apologies if I'm mispronouncing. Out of Watoma, what is your question for us today? Ron, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, what's your question for us today?
Oh, I was asking the question, I've been hearing that veterans that get care out of the VA hospital when they're busy and they can't get you in, I've been hearing that the money that was allotted by Trump when he was president is being used instead of for the veterans, it's being used for the immigrants coming in for their health?
That's a really good question, Ron. And again, we're going to stick with Laura Martin, our Chief of Community Care, who will answer that.
Hi, Mr. Wieske. I don't know that I can answer the part about what your concern was about how it might be used, but I will tell you that we do continue to offer community care to veterans for services that the VA either can't provide or can't provide timely. There are the eligibility requirements in terms of drive time or wait time and a few other options there as well. So if there's care that you need that we cannot provide for you, you start with your primary care provider, and they would enter that referral into us in the community care department.
Thank you, Laura. And then from a financial aspect, I can tell you that we are not running out of money when it comes to community care. That is our job here, to take care of you, our veterans. So no worries there. And thank you for your question. We're going to go on to number three, Mr. Scheidel out of Sparta. Bill, what's your question for us today?
Yes, good afternoon. I had a question regards to, I think we got the first name wrong, but anyway, I had a question regards to the standardized questions that you get asked anytime you come in for an appointment, for whether it's a physical or otherwise. Is there any way that we can opt out, or the veteran can opt out of all those questions? Because I know it's probably pertinent to some, but if you're repetitive in getting this question answered, these questions time and time again, my main question, can we opt out of those?
Great question. We're going to turn this over to Dr. Ellis, our Chief of Staff, to respond.
Sure. Thank you for the question. Most of those questions you're referring to are health screening questions where we ask you about risks for certain diseases. And so there are some requirements that we have because it's good evidence-based practice that we do these things, again, to try to avoid conditions or diseases from occurring. We are working on innovative ways to try to make that entire process easier because I think we all agree that it is sometimes very time-consuming. So the VA is looking into options where you can complete these questionnaires prior to your arrival or while you're waiting to be called back to the waiting room or the exam room to do them on your mobile phone. So there'll be some new technology access options coming soon, hopefully. We're also working to try to reduce them to those, like you said, that are really value added to both your provider and to you in getting to know how to direct your health care.
Great. Thank you, Dr. Ellis, and thank you, Mr. Scheidel. Apologies for the misannouncement of your first name. Definitely recognize you now. But great question, and one that we've heard time and time again, so absolutely we're going to be working on that. Question number four, Ms. Benowski out of Hancock. What's your question for us today?
Yeah, hello.
Hello, what's your question for us today?
Hey, you know what? My question is about that PACT Act screening. I'm not sure if what I had there in last November was the screening or not. It's just kind of a walk-in, like a meet and greet with Dr. Olson down over there, the environmentalist specialist. Was that the screening?
Good question. I'm going to turn this over to Ms. Dorfler, who will be able to answer that question.
Thank you, Mr. Binkowski, for your question. I think what I'd like to do is take a closer look at perhaps what that appointment was, and I think you may be talking about our environmental health clinic, but with the toxic exposure screening and your questions, if it's okay with you, I'd like to give you a call later. Again, this is Natalie Dorfler, nurse practitioner in the environmental health clinic, and we can go through any of your questions and what the next steps may be, whether they're healthcare related and some follow-up might be necessary from a primary or specialty care provider or recommended, or whether it may be a service connection question and you may benefit from following up, or it may be recommended to see your county veteran service officer or contact the Veterans Benefits Administration. Would that be acceptable to you?
Hello?
Binkowski, can you... Would that be acceptable for you?
Yes, sir, it would be. I just got, somehow or another, got misconnected from you folks.
Okay, I'll give you a call later this afternoon, and we'll sort this out.
Okay, thank you very much for your time.
Well, you're very welcome. Thank you.
Excellent. Great question. That's exactly why we're here. And we will move on to the next one. It's a veteran out of, we're not sure where, but it looks like you have a question about maintenance care. Do you want to go ahead and ask your question, sir or ma'am? Yep, we can hear you.
Okay. My question is that with maintenance care, I've had lots of my claims be declined because they say like chiropractor or massage therapy with whole health is not part of the maintenance care program, so they're declining those. So I've been paying out of pocket for those services because I still need to continue it for my pain that I discovered when I deployed. And the other issue is that they say go to the Tomah VA, but if I do go, I schedule an appointment and then I can't be seen another 4 months because, you know, the provider's not there, someone calls in, or, you know, unfortunately people, you know, are lost in their family, and I know that I am sorry for their loss, but when the services need to be provided, that's when I got a community care consult for massage therapy, and I appreciated it, but then when I went to go back to get it, it's like, oh, we can't get you in for another 4 or 5 months. So I don't know. It seems really hard when I'm trying to work on myself that those services are not available and they're declined because of the maintenance care. So if you wouldn't mind, I would love to have a definition of what you call maintenance care, because my community care consult for dental is approved, but I'm not understanding that.
Yeah, excellent question. I'm going to turn this over to our Chief of Whole Health, Kelly.
Yeah, thank you for that question. I know there are a lot of concerns and questions about things like maintenance care. What I can tell you is that our goal in Whole Health is to really focus on functional outcomes and improvements to try, you know, to address pain in a way that helps empower veterans to continue to discover new options for care, new options for, you know, reducing and navigating a life with pain. With regard to maintenance care specifically, those guidelines are outlined in some of our SEOC or situational episode of care documents. And so what oftentimes they're looking at is whether functional outcomes are being made, whether gains are being made. And I would be happy to reach out if you would like and have a conversation about those regulations a little more specifically so that I could answer your questions fully. With regard to getting appointments and being able to access services and care here, we acknowledge that there have been some concerns related to staffing and other situations in our department. We're actively working to try to provide excellent access and care. So that is a work in progress to make sure that we are doing everything we can between, you know, workflow and timing to provide the best care and the most timely care for veterans. So I apologize if you have had a problem, but again, I would be happy to reach out and discuss that further in your condition more specifically if that would be something that you want.
Great. Thank you, Kelly. And great question. Now we're going to go on to Mr. Larson out of La Crosse. Mr. Larson, looks like you got a question about a program at the YMCA.
Yes. Can you hear me?
We can hear you, sir.
Yes. What I wanted to ask about is I am taking efforts to take classes over at the YMCA and work out, but to hire a professional trainer is very expensive, so you kind of go over there and do it on your own. And I found out that Gunderson was looking at tying a program in with the veterans at the YMCA where they would have somebody come over and work with you, especially after you, let's say, had surgery and you wanted to work on certain muscle groups or you wanted somebody to work with you. And I was wondering if the VA has looked at any programs like that. I have a friend down in Iowa who was a Vietnam vet, and he was referred to a gym where they had somebody go in and work with him. Now, for me to go to the gym, I have to drive up to Tomah, which is about 60 miles away, to use the facility up there. And then when I try to go up there, I've gone up a couple times and the person who was supposed to see me was unavailable. So I'm wondering, has anybody looked at programs here with Gunderson? I heard that Gunderson was trying to put something together with a VA.
Yeah, Mr. Larson, that's a great question. I'm going to turn it over to Kelly to answer that.
First of all, I just want to commend you. I think it's absolutely fabulous that you are trying to work on health and fitness and that you're thinking about taking classes at the YMCA. That's a really impressive first step. So that being said, we are looking at further exploration with the YMCA, creating better partnerships with those areas and trying to find ways to offer opportunities at the YMCA or collaborate more fully with them. So what I can tell you is that, yes, there is more to come there, and we're actively working on trying to improve that. But another resource that may be available to you that might be helpful is we have an app called Millennium Health and Fitness that we can provide you with, in which you can engage in virtual health and wellness classes of your choosing. So, for example, you could access yoga classes, Tai Chi classes, strength and fitness classes, all from either your computer or mobile device. We also, in the whole health department, have yoga, Tai Chi, balance, and other classes that we can provide via VVC or Video Virtual Connect. So reach out to the whole health department or let us reach out to you and we can talk to you about fitness opportunities available. And more to come on the YMCA. Thank you.
Excellent question. Thank you, Kelly. And we're going to keep this bus moving because we only got about 10 minutes left. So we're going to have Granham from Sparta. Looks like you got a question about the relationship between Tomah specialty and Madison. What's your question, sir?
Well, I get a lot of my primary care from Tomah, and I'd like to thank you for this opportunity to even ask this question. But I get a lot of specialty care down in Madison at the Middleton VA. There is such a disconnect with my medications that I get from Madison that cannot be renewed through my primary care provider in Tomah. Is there any way to correct that?
Thank you for that question. We're going to ask Ms. Dorfler to take a crack at this one.
Thank you for your question.
I'm sorry, Dr. Ellis.
Sorry. Yep, we're just handing it off. This is Dr. Ellis, your chief of staff. Absolutely. The issue is that our two systems don't always talk to each other. For specialty care, one of the values of doing this through the virtual modalities that Katrine mentioned earlier, like Video Connect or through CBT, is that the prov- provider documents and your Tomah chart. And so all of your care is consolidated out of Tomah, which streamlines everything as far as getting records. We have all of your prescriptions in the Tomah chart. And so for what we're able to offer, and as that opportunity will expand and grow over the next year, we're hoping to be able to make this much easier for you and to make, again, a more seamless experience. But we'll work with you. If you'd like, we can give you a call specifically and see if there's anything else we can do to make this experience better for you, or if you need anything in particular. I can give you a call later this afternoon.
That sound good?
Thank you. Yes, it is. Thanks.
Okay. All right.
Thank you so much for your question. And we're going to go on to the next one, which is looks like Ingling out of Onalaska. Do you have a question for us?
Yes. I had cancer of the throat, and I was under community care with Gunderson. And earlier this month, I was scheduled for an endocrine and imaging, and I was informed that the VA would no longer cover that because the VA is providing the endocrine. Now, the problem I have with that is I have an appointment tomorrow for the endocrine in Onalaska, but I had to call the endocrine office and tell them that they needed to do a blood draw before I went on this appointment. And yes, they did it. Okay, but what about the rest of my care? Are you guys going to terminate that? What?
Mr. Engling, again, sounds like you're very frustrated. We're sorry for that. I think we should give you a call to help go over what's going on so we can get more of the specifics offline without all the audience for your privacy. And then, again, we'll follow up with you to see what's going on. Sorry for the frustrations, but we'll be reaching out to you, okay? We're going to move on to another call. Looks like Mr. Wallace out of Tomah. Do you have a question, sir, on endocrine services?
Yeah, it was a multi-part question. I want to say, for one, I've actually shared something in common with every other question. So it seems to be a common issue with you guys, not specifically you, but the VA as a, in a whole. My question was, how far do endocrine services and labs go as far as health services? Like, so I would like to use it in terms of like sports medicine, monitoring testosterone. And also there at the Tomah VA, you guys have a gym. It used to be open for the veterans to use. Now it's for inpatient only. I was wondering if that could be like reopened, because you guys are big on whole health, but like the guy called in earlier, you guys, the first thing you do is apps, phones. You never put a veteran in access to a physical weight to lift. I would like for you guys to open the gym up. You know, I'm 100% disabled. I would gladly work out every day if I had access to weight. I thought that would be, you know, baseline, something the VA could provide.
Two really good questions, Mr. Wallace. I'm going to have Dr. Nagy talk to you about the endocrine one, and then Kelly again for the gym question. So, Dr. Nagy, you're up first.
Sure. Hi, Mr. Wallace. So thanks for calling in. In terms of testosterone and management, the first step I would suggest you do is just reach out to your primary care provider if you're having a concern. They usually will do an initial screen and just kind of see where your baseline is. And at that point, if further services are needed, then they can refer to the endocrine services here within the Tomah system.
Yes, thank you. And regarding the gym, we do have a fitness gym on site. At Tomah VA, we have hours available for outpatients to come in and utilize that gym. And so typically how that would work is we have a clearance document that should be signed by your primary care provider, just outlining any health concerns. But we can talk to you more about getting that taken care of and talking to you about the outpatient gym. You are speaking, of course, about weights and heavier lifting, so that would be where you get that done. But we do, again, have yoga, tai chi, and other in-person offerings as well if you have any interest. So feel free to reach out to us in Whole Health, or we can contact you as well to give you information about the outpatient for time for the gym.
All right, great questions. We got two left. That's all that the amount of time will allow. So, Ms. Judy Ray, it looks like you got a question about Blue Team. What's your question for us today?
Yes, I have an appointment January of next year for my annual appointment. Are they going to switch that over to the women's clinic only? And why are the women being segregated? I don't mind being around men. I just don't want a man doctor.
Really good question. I'm going to switch this to Dr. Ellis, our chief of staff, to take a stab at it.
Hi there. You are certainly able to choose who you would like your primary care provider to be. And we encourage certainly the women to establish care with a specially trained women's health provider. But if you're happy receiving your primary care with who you are currently doing so, there's no requirement for you to change. We do not have any primary care in the Women's Health Center at this time. It's kind of a dream of ours is to be able to bring a women's health provider over there for the women so that they have access to all of the other services that are located in that facility. You are still more than welcome to come to the Women's Center and engage in any other activities that they may have there or any other appointments that you may want to receive in that space, but there is no requirement for you to do so. But we'd love to see you there.
Great. Thank you, Dr. Ellis. And then real quickly, our last question is, Mr. Edward, looks like you had a bill from a fire department and you have a question about that. What's your question for us today about your bill?
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Yeah, I have a question about my bill. I had to use the ambulance service in Wisconsin Rapids in April 15th. I was on my way in to do my income taxes, and all of a sudden I froze and I couldn't walk, and I finally got to the door where I was going to get in there, and I was stiff, like I couldn't move, and so a few minutes later they asked me if I needed, you think you need an ambulance? I said, I think I might need an ambulance. But they sent me to the local hospital, and that, like I said, that was on April 15th. And then the day before yesterday, I got a bill in the mail that says we do not have your insurance on file. And it was from Wisconsin Rapids Fire Department in Post Office Box in Wheeling, Illinois. And I thought that was kind of odd. Because if it's something that I've always had done around here, I would either be at Tomah, or if I had a copay for some medication or something, it would go like to, was that Oregon or Washington State? And I thought this was kind of nutty. I just didn't know how to explain it to you.
Yep.
But
no,
why would
a
local fire department have a billing from in Illinois, Wheeling?
Yep, it'd definitely be concerning, and we have Mr. Hayes here with Benny Travel to answer your question.
So I wrote your information down because I'm going to have to pull it up in our systems to look and see what's gone on with your ambulance claim, because we'll have to get with another outside agency to, further look into this for you. But after this, I can get back and give you a call.
Great. Thank you, Mr. Hayes. And that's all we have time for questions this afternoon. If we didn't get to your question, please stay on the line because we, in just a moment, we'll have a chance to leave a voicemail with your question, comment, or feedback. We will collect unanswered questions and make sure that you receive the follow-up in the upcoming weeks. And again, we thank you so much for joining us. Again, these town halls are exactly for this session where you guys can get your questions answered. Again, put input into the care that you receive. So again, we really appreciate it. Please look for our future town halls on new topics in the future. And we look forward to talking to you again soon. Have a wonderful day.